Hello friends, in last video we have seen if a force is unknown and an angle made by the force is also unknown, but if resultant is given, you can determine the unknown force F and the angle made by the force using the condition whether the resultant is horizontal or whether the resultant is vertical. We'll see a similar type of problem here. Suppose there is a hook here. So this is a hook, and if this hook is carrying certain loads, this is going in the x direction. Suppose this is a load acting 80 newton, another force acting is also 80 newton, there is one more force acting here 200 newton, and there is one more force here acting F, or let us take this force acting as 100 newton, and this is making an angle of alpha with the horizontal. So you are required to find out the angle alpha such that the resultant is acting horizontally. So here determine alpha and resultant if the hook is pulled along x direction. So this is a problem given to you. A hook is there, there are four forces acting on the hook, and these forces, 100 newton force, the force angle is unknown. You are required to find out the unknown. Given condition is the resultant is moving in x direction. The hook is pulled in the x direction, means the resultant is acting in the horizontal direction. When the resultant is in the horizontal direction, means horizontal component is there. So vertical component will be zero here. So the angles which are given to you in the problem are, this is 30 degrees. This angle is 30 degrees. And this angle is given to us 60 degrees. So four forces. See, whenever we resolve a force, suppose a force is given to you, if you want to resolve this force horizontally and vertically, you should know its magnitude, you should know its direction. You should know its direction either with the horizontal or with the vertical, either with horizontal or with vertical. Now here if you see in this problem, this 80 is making an angle of 30 degrees with the horizontal. Now this 80 newton, he has given you the angle made between these two forces as 30. We don't want that angle. We want the angle made by the force with the horizontal or with the vertical. So what if the angle made by the force with the horizontal? It will be 30 plus 30. So this will be 60 degree. Please don't take 30 as the angle made by the force. We are resolving in the horizontal direction. So angle should be either with respect to horizontal or vertical. Now here, making use of this, we can solve the problem. So first job is to resolve the forces horizontally and vertically. We'll divide it into the resolved components. Now if you see to this, this is the x direction. Now take your pencil, keep it like this along the arrow direction. Now we'll begin with this 80. It is making an angle of 30 degrees. If I resolve it horizontally, we are going along the angle right. Same force, if I resolve it vertically, we are going away from the angle and the direction is up. So let us draw two arrows here. One is right, another is up. This is 80 along, 80 cos of 30, and this is 80 sin of 30. Next, coming to this 80 newton, it is making an angle of 60 degrees. So if I resolve it horizontally, it is along the angle 60 towards right, and if I resolve it vertically, it is away from 60 upwards. So let us draw two arrows here again. This is 80 sin of 60. This is 80 cos of 60. Now coming to this 100 Newton. So this 100 Newton is making an angle of alpha with the horizontal. So if I resolve it horizontally, it is along the angle towards right. So it is along the angle. So this will be right 100 cos of alpha. Similarly, if I resolve the force vertically away from the angle and it is acting upwards. So this force, if I resolve, this will be 100 sine of alpha. Fourth force, this force, it is making an angle of 60 with the horizontal. So we can resolve it. If I resolve it horizontally, it is along the angle right. And if I resolve it vertically, it is away from the angle and the direction is downwards. Suppose if I show those two forces here, this is 200 cos of 60. This will be 200 sine of 60. If you can do this, then there will be no problem for you to resolve the forces. So given, what is given in the problem? You are required to find out alpha such that the resultant is in horizontal direction. Means resultant is in horizontal direction. That means sigma v must be equal to 0. So we will be using these two principles. So let us begin with this. Let us resolve the forces vertically. So there are 1, 2, 3, 4 forces. Up are positive, down are negative. Let us take one by one the force. 80 sine 30 plus 80 sine 60 plus 100 sine of alpha. And this must be equal to 0 because sigma v is 0. So if you simplify this, you get the value of P. If you simplify, you get it will be P sine 100 sine alpha will be equal to 63.92. So sine alpha, if you simplify, you get the value as 0.6392, and the value of alpha, if you simplify, this will be 39.73. So if this has to be satisfied, then the angle made by the 100 Newton force is 39.73. This is one part what he has asked, alpha. He has also asked to find out the resultant. How you get resultant? If you resolve the forces horizontally, that itself will be the resultant. So let us resolve the forces horizontally. Sigma H is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4. All are towards right. 80 cos of 30 plus 80 cos of 60 plus 100 sine of alpha. So now we know the value of alpha. If I substitute that value of alpha, 39.73, this will be equal to resultant. So if you simplify for this, you get the resultant value as 286.18 Newton along x. Along x direction. Suppose if I ask you the same problem along y direction, so what will happen to the condition? Y means vertical, means vertical will be r. That means sigma h will be equal to 0. So knowing the conditions, you can solve the problem. So here, resultant is given, its direction is given, you are required to find out the forces. Like this, anything will be given to you. First, you should be able to resolve the forces correctly. Then only solution will be correct. We have seen if the resolution is wrong, the whole answer will be wrong. So let us take another problem here. So you are required to find out the resultant of a system of forces . This is a hexagon and the forces are acting from the point O. So this is one force acting, which is 10 Newton. There is another force acting here in this direction, and this force is 40 Newton. There is one more force acting along this, and this is 20 Newton. And there is one more force here acting this is 50 Newton and there is a four force acting here, 15 Newton. So all the forces are meeting at O. So this is coplanar concurrent forces. So you have to resolve the forces horizontally and vertically. Now here only forces are given to you. Figure is a hexagon. These angles are not given to you. So in case of hexagon, you know each of the angle will be 30 degrees, 30 degrees, 30 degrees, and 30 degrees. 30, 30, 30, 90. So this is horizontal and vertical, plus this is 90. Now, we are required to resolve the forces. So whenever you resolve a force, you should know the angle made by the force, either with horizontal or with the vertical. Now if you see to this force, this is horizontal, so its vertical component will be 0. This 40 is making an angle of 30 degrees with the horizontal. This 20 Newton, he has given this is 30 plus 30. So the angle made by this force with the horizontal is 60 degrees. Now this force is vertical, so its horizontal component will be 0. This force, it is making an angle of 30 degrees with the vertical. Okay, either with horizontal or with the vertical. Now suppose if I resolve these forces horizontally and vertically, let us draw the resolved components. So this force is acting horizontally towards right. It is acting towards right. Now coming to this force, 40, see how to keep your pencil. This is your pencil. Arrow direction is like this, downwards. So hold it here. See, now if you resolve it horizontally, it is along the angle 30. If I resolve it vertically, we are going away from 30. But see the directions. This is left direction and this is downward direction. So let me resolve by using this arrow. Now here the force is acting like this. See, 40 along the angle left. Similarly, 40 away from the angle 30, it is acting downwards. So let us draw two arrows here. One is left, another is down. So this will be 40 cos of 30. This will be 40 sine of 30. Now let me come to this 20. See, 20 is acting like this as usual. Arrow is like this. If I resolve it horizontally, we are moving along an angle of 60 degrees and the direction is right. Similarly, if I resolve the force vertically, we are going away from the 60 and it is acting upwards. So if I show two arrows here, one is right, another is up. This is 20 cos of 60 and this is 20 sine of 60. Now coming to this force, this 50 is acting vertically up. So just show that force here vertically up is 50 Newton. No horizontal component. Now here one more is left out. See how the force is acting. It is acting downwards like this. So hold it here because I know the angle here. If I resolve it horizontally, what is happening? I am going away from the angle and see where is the direction? Towards right. Similarly, same force. If I resolve it vertically, I am going along the angle and the direction is downwards. So if I show these two forces, this if I resolve is going right, this if I resolve it is going down. So this is away. Away is 15 sine 30 and this is 15 cos of 30. So once you are able to draw this, then finding resultant is not a big problem. So sigma h is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4 are horizontal, right positive, left negative. So this force is 10 Newton. 10 plus 20 cos 60. This is left. Minus 40 cos of 30. This is right. Plus 15 sine of 30. If you simplify this, you get sigma h is equal to minus 7.14 Newton. Similarly, if I resolve the forces vertically, 1, 2, 3, 4 forces are vertical, up are positive, down are negative. So here let us begin with this 20 sine of 60, then 40 sine of 30, it is acting down, minus 40 sine of 30. This 50 is acting up, so plus 50. This 15 cos 30 is acting down, so it will be minus 15 cos 30. If you simplify this, you get sigma V is equal to 34.3 Newton. So resultant R is given by under root sigma H square plus sigma V square. So this will be equal to under root sigma H is minus 7.14 square plus 34.3 square. So this is equal to, if you simplify, you get 35.05. And be careful here, this minus square will become plus. So don't write minus and this, then the value will be less. Another hint I told you is, this value what we calculate should be greater of these two values. Now we'll go for the direction. Tan theta is given by sigma V by sigma H. So here sigma V is 34.3 and sigma H is minus 7.14. So you get the value of theta is equal to minus 78.25. Minus 78.25. So how many steps you have followed? Sigma H, sigma V, R, theta. Four steps. One more step is, in which quadrant the force will lie, resultant force will lie. For deciding that, see the direction of sigma H and sigma V. Sigma H is negative and sigma V is positive. Means this is which quadrant? This is in second quadrant. So resultant lies in second quadrant. So you should mention here. So since sigma H is negative, sigma V is positive, resultant lies in the second quadrant. So this value of resultant is 35.05 and it is making an angle of 78.25. So we have replaced all the system of forces by a single force. So this is how we will be finding out the values for concurrent, coplanar, concurrent forces. All forces are meeting at a point. So resultant will also pass through the same point. So another category problem is to find out the resultant of non-concurrent forces. Non-concurrent means all forces will not be meeting at a point. So we'll see in the next video. Thank you. Please like, share, subscribe for the channel and press the bell icon for any queries. Thank you.